Hello everyone, I am Yasani. Today we will learn about the logistic regression and later we will see what is the difference between the linear and the logistic regression. So we will start from the linear regression. So what is the linear regression? In the linear regression, there is the linear relationship between the dependent variable y and the independent variable x. It is used for the cases where we want to predict some continuous quantity. The main attribute of the linear regression is the continuous quantity. So in the graph we see that there are the points which are shown in the yellow color are the actual values, and the dashed line is the best fitted linear line. Okay, this is showing the linear regression between the independent variable x and the dependent variable y. The equation which is used to show the linear regression model is y equal to v0 plus v1x plus e. Here y is the dependent variable, v0 is the y-intercept, v1 is the slope or the coefficient of the independent variable x, and e is the error. Error is the difference between the actual value and the predicted value. The predicted value is calculated with the help of the linear regression model. Okay, so this is all about the linear regression. Now we see that what is the logistic regression. The logistic regression most of the same as the linear regression. The difference is that in the case of the logistic regression, the dependent variable is the categorical. So now what is the meaning of the categorical? The categorical means binary value, 0 or 1, yes or no condition, absence or presence, okay, A or B. So these are the cases of the categorical values. So in the case of the logistic regression, the dependent variable is the categorical variable. Okay, the equation which is used to represent the logistic regression is log y upon 1 minus y equal to c plus b1 x1 plus b2 x2 plus so on. Now in the case we see that now in the graph we are seeing that the best fitted curve in the curve of the logistic regression is the S-shaped curve. Okay, now we are seeing that here y is the probability of an event to happen which you are trying to predict. So y value will give you the probability of the event. X1, x2 are the independent variables which determine the occurrence of an event. C is the constant term which will be the probability of the event happening when no other factors are considered. Here suppose that the y is equal to 0.5, then in this case we can say that the values which are 0 to 0.5 will be considered as 0, and the values which will be 0.5 to 1 will comes into the category of the 1. So the output will be 0 or 1 only. So y is called the threshold value, and the value of the y will be between 0 to 1 because y is the probability. Okay, so now we see that linear regression use case where we can use the linear regression. Linear regression is generally used in the case of the business, in the R&D, and this is the simplistic case. Suppose that we have to forecast the monthly sales by studying the relationship between the monthly e-commerce sales and the online advertising costs. Now we are seeing that in the first column are the monthly sales and in the second column is the advertising cost. So when we plot the graph, we are seeing that the best fitted curve is the linear curve. When we are using the linear regression, we can see that when we increasing the advertising cost, then we can say that the monthly sales is also increasing. So there is the positive linear regression. Okay, there is the positive linear regression because when we are increasing the advertising cost, the monthly e-commerce sales also increasing respectively. Okay, now we will see that case of the logistic regression. Suppose that we have to predict if a student will get admitted to a school based on the CGPA. Now we see that in the first column there is the admission status, which is 0 or 1, and there are the respective CGPA are given in the second column. The 0 is shown that the student will not get admitted to the school, and the 1 is showing that the student admitted to a school based on the CGPA values. Now we see that the students which have the CGPA 4.2, 5.1, 5.5 falls in the category of the 0 values, or we can say that they will not get admitted in the school, and the which have the values 8.2, 9 and 9.1 they will falls in the category of the 1, and we can say that they will get admitted to a school. Okay, so this is the case of the logistic regression. Now we will see what is the difference between the linear regression and the logistic regression on the some parameters. Now the first column is showing the parameters, second is the case of the linear regression, and third column showing the logistic regression. So on the first parameter is the definition. So according to the definition, the linear regression is used to predict a continuous dependent variable based on a value of independent variables. Okay, and the definition of the logistic regression is it is used to predict a categorical dependent variable based on the values of the independent variable. The only difference is that between the linear and logistic regression, that in the linear regression we are using the continuous dependent variable, and in case of the logistic regression we are using the categorical dependent variable. The variable type in the linear regression is the continuous dependent variable, and in the logistic regression there is the categorical dependent variable. The estimation method is used in case of the linear regression is the least square estimation. It means there will be the error. We know that in case of the linear regression error always occurred, so we have to minimize the error. There the error should be least, so it's the least square estimation method. And in the the logistic regression is the maximum likelihood estimation. We have to increase the probability, maximizing the probability. The equation which is used in the linear regression is the y is equal to b0 plus b1x plus e, and in case of the logistic regression, equation is log y upon 1 minus y equal to c plus b1x1 plus b2x2. The best fit line in case of the linear regression is the straight line, and we know that in case of the logistic regression this is the curve, which is the S-shaped curve. The relationship between the dependent variable and independent variable in case of the linear regression, the linear regression relationship between the dependent and independent variable. In case of the linear regression, there is the linear relationship, and in case of the logistic regression, the linear relationship is not mandatory, because we know that in case of the linear regression, there are the categorical values. The output in case of the linear regression is the predicted integer value. In case of the logistic regression, there is the binary values. The applications of the linear regression are in the business domain, forecasting sales, etc. And the applications of the logistic regression is the it is used in the classification problem, cyber security, image processing, etc. So this is all about the linear regression and the logistic regression. Thank you.